Good afternoon. My name is Andrea Campagnier and I am a PhD student at the University of Milano Bicocca. In this presentation, I will summarize the contents of our paper titled Weighted Utility, a utility metric based on case-wise raters' perception. So, to start, despite the increasing interest toward artificial intelligence systems and the growing number of successes reported in the literature of these systems, there still remain two important gaps and limitations that limit the deployment and applicability of these systems in real-world decision settings, especially so-called critical ones, like the medical field. These two gaps are called usually in the literature the chasm of human trust and the chasm of machine experience. The chasm of machine experience refers to problems related to data reliability and data vetting processes. On the other hand, the chasm of human trust regards all processes that are related to the building of trust that the user can have on the artificial intelligence systems. This regards, for example, the validation and evaluation of the artificial intelligence systems. Focusing more on this second kind of gap, it is important to underline that trust is a complex dimension, which usually refers to the fact that the decision maker, the user of this artificial intelligence system, to use effectively this system, should find that the artificial intelligence system and the provider of these systems are to be considered reliable and trustworthy. In this sense, trust is a complex notion that can be considered as the composition of different properties. Some of them have the perceived ability of the artificial intelligence systems, its predictability, and also there are properties that regard more in particular the vendor of the artificial intelligence system, for example, its integrity or its benevolence. Obviously, these last two properties are more difficult to evaluate, and so the focus in artificial intelligence studies has been more on the first two points. In particular, when mapping these two notions on concepts that are more common in the artificial intelligence literature, we can see that perceived ability is clearly mapped to the accuracy of artificial intelligence systems, and so we can evaluate the perceived ability of these systems in terms of the many different metrics that have been proposed in the literature. For example, we have accuracy, or also the area under the curve, or also, for example, the F-score. On the other hand, predictability can be mapped to the concept of reproducibility. So asking whether the artificial intelligence system, when deployed in a setting which is different from the one it has been built on, whether this system will still perform well. It is in particular in regard to the first dimension, so accuracy, that the interest in artificial intelligence system has been increasing. This has been primarily due to the fact that an increasing number of scientific articles have reported that these artificial intelligence systems to be very accurate, and in some cases as accurate as or even more accurate than decision maker. This happened, for example, in radiological or imaging-based tasks in medicine. However, an important point is that this accuracy result should not impress us much for two main reasons. The first is that, as I said before, accuracy is a different concept from reproducibility. So we may have a system that has reported a very huge, very high accuracy in its validation based on data from settings similar to the training one, but could perform much worse in real-world settings. The second problem is that current accuracy and the current accuracy metrics can be considered a fictional construct because they do not take into account important biases and limitations of the kind of information that we use for evaluating system. For example, if these kind of metrics are usually based on checking whether the decision provided by artificial intelligence systems are equal to a given set of annotations. The problem is that it is not always clear how these annotations are collected and if they can be considered accurate or correct, because, for example, that could be phenomena like inter-rater disagreement that is very much common in medical settings. Also, these kind of annotation do not take in consideration the different perception of decision makers. For example, it could be that a wrong decision in a given case is less impactful than a wrong decision on another case. So to address these limitations, in this article, we proposed a new metric that we called the weighted utility, which is not based on accuracy, standard accuracy metrics, but is, on the other hand, a generalization of a utility metric, which is called the net benefit. You can see the formula for the weighted utility on the bottom part of the slide. And in the next slides, on the other hand, I will try to explain a little more this very complex mathematical formulation. So to start, from an intuitive perspective, it is clear that decision support and artificial intelligence system should be considered useful only if the number of times it gives correct classification is greater than the number of times it gives wrong classifications. This is a very obvious property, and it is the property that every accuracy measures actually take in consideration. However, to this dimension, we also add other three properties. The first is that the artificial intelligence system should be optimized to avoid the most impactful kind of error. For example, in the cases of a medical setting, it may happen that misclassifying a patient to be healthy when instead he has a given deathly disease is more impactful than the converse case. The second property is that the artificial intelligence system should be more helpful and more useful on the cases where you need it most. For example, on the cases that are considered more difficult and so are more difficult to automate, or on the rarest case on which the decision maker is less familiar. The third property is that the artificial intelligence system should not take guesses, and so its decision should be informed and confident enough. These are obviously a lot of information, and so one could ask, how can we obtain all this information? Our answer in the paper is that since these systems are to be used by the decision makers, we should involve the decision maker in the validation process and in the elicitation of these pieces of information. So in regard to the first property, essentially here we are asking what is the impact of false positives. For example, in the medical setting, this could be considered the cost of overtreatment or the risk of anxiety of the patients. These elements is ultimately encoded into a probability threshold, which is called tau. This is a very common information that is used in utility-based metrics. However, a common difficulty that we have in real-world problems is how to elicit this kind of information. Indeed, it is not always easy to have decision makers to elicit probabilities. So we also propose a technique for which this threshold can be inferred automatically based on the behavior, annotation behavior of the decision makers. The second element, so in regard to the to understanding on which cases the support of the artificial intelligence system is most needed, we encode this information in the form of a relevance function, which is essentially a mapping from instances or cases to 0, 1, where to the numbers between 0, 1, where 1 means the maximum possible relevance and 0 means that an element is not relevant at all. Also in this case, there can be many different ways in which we can collect information about relevance. For example, we can label cases as relevant according to the accuracy of good raters. For example, a case on which all or most of the raters err could be considered most relevant because we need very much the help of the artificial intelligence system in these cases. Another way is to directly ask the decision maker to give a subjective assessment of the relevance of the cases. The third element regards the confidence of the artificial intelligence systems on the other end. The rationale behind this item is that we intuitively we would not trust a decision maker that flips a coin to make a decision. So obviously we should require the artificial intelligence system to satisfy the same property. In this case, we use another probability threshold, which is called sigma in this case, that can be collected, for example, by either by setting a given threshold value, for example, 75%. So we should require that the probability score for the decision expressed by the artificial intelligence system should be at least as high as this value, or we can also ask the confidences that are required by the decision makers. In the article, we prove that our proposed metric is a generalization of the net benefit and also of other common accuracy metrics, for example, the balanced accuracy, the specificity and sensitivity. And we also perform a simple experiment in a radiological setting in which we illustrate the application, our metric can be applied, and how all parameters that are required to its computation can be collected and computed. And we show in particular that depending on the setting of the parameters, our metrics can be very flexible. So this ends my presentation, and thank you for your attention. If you have any questions, you can also write me by email. Thank you.